I'm not gonna lie to you guys, today is not the day. I woke up feeling fine, but pretty sure right after this, I'm gonna go curl up in bed with a heating pad on my belly. Oh, my air conditioner is on. All right. My name is Shaylin, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm really sorry if I seem like very low energy today. I think I'm gonna put it in from the beginning, but today is not the day. Not feeling so hot, hence why I'm sitting literally on the floor. I didn't have the energy to even pull out my bar stools and set up my camera on my bar stool and sit on the other one. That's just the reality, and I have said in past videos that I want to be very raw and real with you guys, so that's what you're getting. Today was the only day this week that I could film this, so this is what you're getting. I'm sorry, but I'm gonna push through, and we're in this together, so I guess that makes it somewhat better. So, as you can see from the title of this video, today's video is part two of this small little two-part gym series. I explained that all in last week's video. If you missed it, I'll put a little card up here, I think. I think I put the cards up here. If not, it's up here. But anyway, if you didn't watch last week's video and you wanna learn my ab and arm routine, or if you're just interested to see how I work out as a woman with hemiplegia, then go check that out. I'm gonna try and speed through the beginning of this video and more efficiently explain the cardio a bit. So basically, let's get started right now. I'm gonna pop my little, actually I'm gonna do it on this side this time because I am a little bit off center, I guess. Over here, I'm gonna pop up my little workout layout. I ended up learning that it's called the split, like the workout layout that I was talking about in the last video. Anyway, it's up on the screen. Got cardio, main focus, and stretching. For cardio, I do one of two things. I either do the elliptical, which if I'm doing the elliptical, I do 30-second intervals of a normal pace, and then a faster pace for 5 minutes in total. And then if I'm on the treadmill, I walk at a fast pace for 2 minutes, run slash jog for 1 to 2 minutes, and then I do like a 1 to 2 minute cool down. As I mentioned in the last video, this week's video for part two, we're going over legs and stretching. So let's start with legs. First, I don't always do this, but I wanted to include this. I do this right after I'm done doing my cardio, just to kind of give my left leg and hip some action. Basically, I just call it single leg treadmill focus. And I really just do this for like 5 minutes or so, just to get in some like very mindful leg and foot engagement. I'm not really sure how to explain this, but basically I like pressing my right hip on the like handle of the treadmill so I have some stability there, so I know not to like compensate with my hip, because when I walk, if you've ever noticed, I tend to hike my hip up, like my left hip, to compensate for not being able to lift my leg very well. But basically, I'm really focusing on the hip also, but mostly my ankle activation, because I have no dorsiflexion in my foot when I'm walking. It just kind of like flops down flat foot. I really have to concentrate and focus on activating my ankle if I can at all. I also don't always do squats, but if I do on the Smith machine, and 3 sets of 10 reps. Okay, so I have a bit of like an improvement for this exercise. For calf raises, I used to stand on the side of a treadmill and just use my body weight to do 3 sets of 5 reps. And this was just to activate my calf muscles a little bit. As I got better with that, I started wanting more weight. So I tried to hold on to like a weighted ball like I do with my Russian twists from the last video. I found that that was kind of hard to balance like that. So I graduated to a different one. I saw a girl at my gym doing this one day and it kind of gave me inspiration to do my calf raises like this. The most recent way I've been doing my calf raises is with the Smith machine. So I'll put down like 2 weight plates underneath the Smith machine. I usually do like the 10 pound weights and I just kind of like go up on my toes on the weight plate. So 50 pounds and 3 sets of 10 reps. And then for this exercise, I have a bit of a journey that I went through with this as well. For a long time, I was just doing split squats, like one to the front, one to the side, one to the back, and I would just do that, I think, 3 times holding a weighted ball. I found that I wanted to gear my split squats more towards working on my glutes. So I wanted to do split squats with one leg on the bench behind me. So I started doing that. Obviously you can tell in the video, looks really challenging because I can't really keep my balance. I had to like stare at one point on the ground and like not look away or shift my focus for anything because I would fall right over if I did that. So anyway, I came up with this idea most recently where I do my split squats on the Smith machine. I think I only do 10 pounds. I'm pretty sure. It's a lot easier to hold on to the bar with my leg up on the bench and squat that way. That way I have my balance. I can really focus on my form and where my weight is sitting, like into my heels more. This one's pretty self-explanatory. I've been doing this for a while. On the curl and extension machine, I'm starting with my right leg extensions and I do 130 pounds. And I keep it to 5 reps because it is really challenging to do. But basically I do 130 pounds for my right leg extensions. Then for left leg extensions, I do 100 pounds and again, 3 sets of 5 reps. For leg curls, there is something, just like in the last video, I had to refer back to something that I said the first time that I filmed this video because I thought that I said it really well. There is something that I thought I had to include in the last video, but it's actually for leg day. So, and it's about leg curls. So I'm gonna roll that clip right now. Paralysis, you might have heard from either your physiotherapists or your doctors that any motion forwards is so much easier than any motion going backwards. So putting my arm forward this way isn't really an issue for me. It kind of is, but minimal struggle. And then anything going backwards, I kind of can't even go past where my shoulder is, for my arm at least. So same thing goes for my leg. It's a lot easier to kick forward than it is kicking backwards. And we're back. So that being said, it's definitely challenging regardless to do extensions with my left leg. But definitely with the curls, it's a lot harder. So for my right leg, I do, right now I'm currently at 100 pounds I do with my right leg. Again, 3 sets of 5 reps. But then for my left leg, as it is like extremely challenging and one of the hardest exercises that I do out of anything that I do at the gym, I will give myself a pat on the back though, because I've made it to 50 pounds from whatever the lowest amount is on that machine. I'm pretty sure it's like 10 pounds. So props to me. I worked really hard and I'm really proud of myself, honestly, that I made it all the way to 50 pounds for my left leg curls. So again, 3 sets of 5 reps for that one. And then I have a bit of a progression for this exercise as well. For hip thrusts, I started out with my shoulders on a bench and I would use a weight plate from the Smith machine. I think I only used like 25 pounds, and that was only because that was all I could carry with my one arm and like shift over to my lap from the bench. If I went any heavier, I would have had to have my husband grab the plate for me and put it on my lap for me. So that being said, this way of doing hip thrusts was not efficient and not practical at all for myself. So anyway, I wanted to include that if anybody wanted like a beginner way of doing hip thrusts. But I will say, if you're at a gym who has a bar, like a free bar where you can load plates up onto it, that would be way easier to roll up to you to do your hip thrusts. My gym doesn't have that though. That's the only reason that I couldn't do that, and I had to use the free weights from the Smith machine. But anyway, again, if there's any beginners out there who need some a different variation of hip thrusts to do a lower weight, this would be a good alternative, I guess. And then I wanted to show you how I got into position when I switched over to doing it on the curl and extension machine, which was my next progression into how I do my hip thrusts now. So I wanted to keep this in because this was kind of a harder way to get into position for hip thrusts, and I wish that I knew the way that I do it now instead of doing it this way. But anyway, this is how I used to get into it. It's extremely awkward and not practical again, but you know, I was just kind of feeling out how to do it. But now, this is how I get into position for hip thrusts. A lot easier. As you can see, I adjust the two bars, like the bars with the pads, and then I slide myself down and kind of just walk myself out until my shoulders are on the seat, and then I drop the, and you have to be very careful when you're doing this because you could probably hurt yourself quite a bit, but I do it very slow and very carefully. But basically you just drop the bar down and kind of go into like a seated position. And then you start your hip thrusts. And right now I'm doing 160 pounds and I do 3 sets of 10 reps with that. And then again, I wanted to leave in how I got out of that position, just in case you wanted to do this version of hip thrusts. Now you know how to get out of it. All right, now moving on to probably my favorite part of any workout that I do at the gym, stretching. So, if you know me personally, you would know that I was a dancer from ages, I think, 3 years old. Oh, I think I said this in the last video. Anyway, if you didn't watch my video last week, then I was a dancer from ages 3 until 17, up until I had my stroke, basically. And I was a very flexible person growing up, and obviously I've been out of commission. I haven't danced like the way that I used to, I mean. I haven't danced the way I used to in 6 years now. It's been almost 6 years since my stroke. So basically, as I said in the last video, I'm just trying to get back to my old ways, and it's honestly very beneficial for your physical and mental health to be flexible, and yeah, it honestly helps you with your workouts even. But anyway, this is kind of like my little stretching routine that I like to do whenever I'm done working out. I grab a yoga mat and this is what I do. First exercise that I like to do to really just open up my hips. If you're a dancer, you know that opening up your hips and will help you with your turnout. Not that I need good turnout anymore or anything like that, but it just feels good on my hips and it's something that I like to do. So this one I call the butterfly stretch. Next is split stretches. So here I'm doing my left leg split stretch forward. And then I like to lean backwards and stretch out my right quad while I'm already in that position. And I do the opposite legs. So my right leg split stretch forward. And then left leg quad stretch. And when I got out of that, I just did a little forward bend toe touch to stretch out my hamstrings. Before I do my straddle stretch, I like to grab the heaviest weighted ball that my gym has, which is a 20 pound ball. And I like to use that to kind of like push myself forward, and kind of just like helps me like reach towards a goal. If I like tap it and push it a little bit farther forward, I try really hard to reach for it. But yeah, basically now I spread out my legs and I do my middle split forward stretch. And then, as I mentioned before, I like to push myself to go further than I'm comfortable with, because that's how you're going to get more flexible, is if you make yourself uncomfortable. So I push myself a little bit further. And then I put, hug your legs, they did a good job. Which is very true. You definitely want to thank your body for everything that it does for you when you're pushing it to do things that make you uncomfortable. So I I feel like I got through this video pretty fast, which isn't a bad thing. I'm kind of hoping that this video is gonna be a little bit shorter than the last one anyway. That wraps up my little mini two-part gym series, I guess. If you guys have any more gym content that you guys want to see, make sure you drop that in the comments below and let me know what you want to see. I did notice we are creeping up on our 100 subscriber goal really fast, and I didn't really expect it to happen this quickly. So I'm getting a little bit nervous about filming my stroke story video. I'm gonna have to start prepping for that soon. But yeah, I mean, I'm not complaining. Thank you so much for all the subscribers. I'm like super excited that you guys are here and wanting to watch me and support me and my channel. And yeah, it's just really exciting things. So, and I forgot to say in my last video, and almost forgot to say this before I closed out this video, I do have an affiliation code with a company called Astoria Activewear. I'm actually wearing a set from them right here. It's very cute, it's pink, and it has like an open back. But yeah, it's super comfortable, very supportive sports bra. So yeah, I'll put my discount code up on the screen. But yeah, I just wanted to kind of drop that here because I forgot to say it in the last video, and I almost forgot to say it here. I always have the code and the link to the website in the description of all my videos. So if you're interested, go ahead and follow the link in the description. And make sure you use my code to save you some coin, because who doesn't like saving money anyway? But like I always say, if you guys know anybody with honestly any type of physical disability, but specifically hemiplegia, this would be a great video to share with them, maybe boost their confidence, kill any nerves they have about maybe starting to go to the gym, or give them some extra ideas on how they can do different exercises at the gym to improve their physical health. I know it was really hard for me to step foot in a gym. Self-confidence wise, I wasn't very great in that department. But the gym has honestly made me feel so much better and so much more confident in myself. So I would highly recommend anybody to definitely exercise at least like a few times a week. But also, yeah, it just really, I've had nothing but great things to say about going to the gym so far. So again, if you guys have any questions or any suggestions, I'm here for the feedback. Let me know. My DMs are open on Instagram, or even the comments down on this video. Once again, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.